said, oh, all right.
Lovely to see you.
Lovely to see you too, Geoffrey. Hello. Well, thank you so much for everyone who's come here today. It's a real privilege to stand up here. It really is, and I don't take it lightly. And to stand up here with people like Jill, who spoke, wow, those words are just
amazing.
Worship team for that wonderful part of worship there. And I just want to start with a prayer before I start with the exhibition really. And I want to thank you, Lord, for us all being here today. Thank you, Lord, for us being here in unity. Thank you for us being here for one purpose, to pray for the peace of Jerusalem, to pray for Israel, pray for their enemies, pray for the allies, and I pray for blessing upon today. And I pray, Lord, that every word spoken would really speak into each and every one of us and into our hearts, and that we can go forward and tell others about the wondrous miracle of what Israel is today.
Amen.
And that is what the work you are doing today, Lord, for each and every one of us. So I'm going to start off with the exhibition. I don't know if you've noticed the photos around the room. Hard work has gone into these photos, and a lot of care. And thank you to the team who sorted that out for, as part of the whole thing. So I'm going to start off from over here. Am I okay to move, Dave, or do you want to stay here?
No, you can move.
Stay here.
No move if you want.
Okay, so we're going to start from over here. I don't know if all of you can see this photo, but please, at the end, you feel free to get up if you want to move around with me, or you can just have a look later on. So I'm going to start off with this photo here.
Yes.
This photograph is of, it's quite, you don't know what it is at first. It's a bomb shelter in Caparaza. It's the line to where behind it there are supposed to be 30 people fit behind that line. And across the other side are where the bombs are. So I wanted to start with this image as it's the line where it's drawn, that's where it starts. That's the line of safety and danger. So How many seconds is it? 15 seconds to get across the line. So it's such a dangerous place, but God is there. And as you'll see as I go around the exhibition, you'll see that. So then we've got the next picture in the corner over here. Kobe Sharush. Yeah, just make sure I get his surname right there. He is the head of security in Starop. Not an easy job. This man is amazing. He dedicates his whole life, his time, his energy into protecting the people of Starop. And without him, there would be chaos. So, also remember him in your prayers when you're praying for Starop. He's got a difficult job. When I spoke to him, he was saying the things that he's seen are just absolutely, you can't wrap your mind around it. Things that he has to go through day to day, and the people of Starop, and things that they have to go through. So his story is amazing. We're going to be making a Kindle book at some point in the next couple of months, where we're going to have a small snippet of exactly the details on each photograph. You'll be able to read about Kobe and a bit about his story. This is Anna Kibbutzin. She is Jimmy's wife, widow, and in the photo next to Anna is the memorial to Jimmy. This memorial was absolutely incredible. It was really breathtaking. He died, he was in his garden, and a rocket came over, and he died. Just in his garden, and we take for granted here how safe we are. You wouldn't ever think of going out to your garden being hit by a rocket, would you? But there, it's a real threat. So this is in Kafraza, and it looks over the valley. And Anna, and she showed me around, she showed me to his memorial. And she's an amazing woman, and the things that she's been through and what she's advocating for her, for Jimmy. And it's amazing the things that she's got to say, and as I said, it will be in the Kindle book when it's ready. So this is Arion and his mother. Arion is a wonderful little boy from Sterot. He is severely traumatized from the rockets. When you see, you know, young lads here, you know, you see like a Bastion Kitty's children, you see them bouncing around. He wasn't like that. He was really scared, constant fear. Any little crash, anything, he'd run to his mum. And as you can see there, they're very, very close. And his mum was saying to me how he didn't leave the house for 3 months. Didn't leave the house. He was too scared. He couldn't go to school. He couldn't go. He couldn't do anything. And she's saying just how her life has been turned upside down by the terrorism and the trauma. And there'll be more in the book about that, but it's a really sad story. But at the same time, you can still see that no one can take away the love. Oh, you can see that, can't you? You know it. And while I was in Kafraza, I went round to the youth club, and there were lovely kids. Right, they were really lovely, and they didn't want to show their faces, but this was the what they called the soft room. So they had mattresses, they had blankets, they had cushions all over the floor, and this was their safe place, because there's not many safe places, you know. Sorry, I'm behind the pillar, here we are. And they just felt comfortable there, and that was where they felt safe. And that really impacted me, and how it's just such a small room, but that's where they felt safe. And then I went, and then this picture on the corner here with the yellow sofa, it's quite a run-down youth group, really. The church had donated a lot of money to them while I was there, and apparently they have done some good changes there, but you know, they didn't want to show their faces, and that was the bomb shelter where that sofa is. They had to fit all the children in it when the alarm goes off. And this room was tiny, tiny room, you think. And they had to stay, I remember the youth worker there telling me that you had to stay in there for 8 hours. All these, you know, from, you know, about 10 years old, 16 years old, 8 hours in a room. You know, you can't imagine the children here but having to go through that, can you? So that was quite difficult to see, really. But it's important to show this, because it's reality. You know, you have to have a reality check, and that's the truth of it. And the one next to that, just back one, with the children from an advocacy's charity. And they were playing with the water there, but you can see the happiness on their faces, but you know that they're always close by. You know, kids here just wrap all over the place, but they stay close. And I could see that there was sort of an unspokenness about that. But they're being happy there. And then this is in the corner over here. This is Oriane. This is Nervi's daughter. This is in the playground in Kafraza. As you can see there, she looks really happy, but parents don't let the children. They're very concerned about the children being there, as it's open air. So the rockets can hit any time, and you know, as I was saying earlier, the bomb shelter is 15 seconds. There's one really close to the playground, but when she's up there, you know, you don't know, do you? So she wanted me to take photos of her. And I thought, I wanted to capture the happiness while it was there, you know, and it's such a beautiful. That's the new playground that the church donated to as well. It's beautiful. It's really gorgeous. Kids love it. But as I said, it's open air, and that is, you know, it's not easy for parents to deal with that. And then, as we move along here, the other advocacy's charity is just there. And what I wanted to tell you about as well is other advocacy's story. I'm sure you've all heard it now. It's a young girl who worked at this place here. It's the youth club, children's work. Sophia hit, and she jumped on her brother to protect him, and the shrapnel went into her brain, and she died instantly, but protecting her brother. And that's what her father, who's in the photo there, with the children running around him, that's what you can see there. He was an amazing man. He just said, all I want to do is just show the life, Ella's life, through this.
Amen.
And we do it all free. All the children can come here, and they can just enjoy their summer in safety, which is so important. And Ella was one of the youth workers in the blue there. And that's what she used to do, and they all remember her, and they all pay tribute to her. And they were amazing group of teenagers. They were absolutely incredible. You think what they were doing just was incredible to me. And they were lovely, and they wanted to show their gratitude to Ella through these photos. Some of these three here are the children playing at the youth group. It was lovely to see them just having a good time. And that's what I wanted to show. I wanted to show the seriousness of the situation in Caparazos through these photos here, but I also wanted to show the life through the children, because that's where it comes from. And then ending with this final photograph here. This was in the kindergarten in Caparazos. And a little boy and his little builder's helmet on, and that I just took a picture of that. I just captured that, and I thought, they've all got to be strong, even from toddlers. They all realise, they all see the threat, but they're all staying strong. The kindergarten was a bomb shelter. The whole thing was a bomb shelter, huge, thick concrete roof. Quite sad to see in many ways, but also it was good to see that they were staying. So that is the exhibition. As I said, it will be available on Kindle Book soon. But please feel free to have a look at the photographs in greater detail, because seeing them from the chair isn't always the best way to see them. So please have a look. Any questions you have, please come and ask me, and I'd be more than happy to answer. So I just want to express really how much we should pray. I count all of these people in my prayers. I know that. And how much Sderot is so close to my heart, is so close to the church's heart, has been for years, and know me and the family as well, how close they are to us all. And please pray for them. And I want to include that in today's prayers as well, as we pray as we intercede to Israel today. So, if you can include that.